Well, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to another one of these fucking streams. Today we are going to play LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga, episodes 7 and 8. And now let's make sure that... Hey, that's me. Wow. Wow, it's a beautiful boy. But we're not here to watch beautiful boys. I assume I do not have the time for episode 9. I will be going through these as fast as possible, mainly because I don't like these episodes one bit. Episode 7 started off okay-ish, but episode 8 got off track completely with the whole fucking Emperor Snoke shit. I mean, Emperor Snoke was kind of a big deal, and then he just got fucked in episode 8, and episode 9 just was Palpatine once again. But yeah, episode 7 picked up somewhere in a weird spot. But hey, Naomi, welcome.
The Force Awakens.
I never really liked episodes 7, 8, and 9. I know episode 7 is the strongest of the bunch, because episode 8 and 9 are completely garbage compared to episode 7. For me, at least, episode 9 kind of picked up where episode 8 left off, but they had to fix all of the shit that the main that episode 7 and 8 did, which is a big problem, because episode 7 gave a decent premise with Emperor Snoke and everything. You know, who the hell is he? And then he turns out to be a Palpatine clone, kinda. I don't know. Was he a pawn or a clone? I don't really remember anymore, but yeah, just the whole charade with Emperor Snoke. We never truly learn where the Resistance comes from after Palpatine died.
Huh? Where do you come from?
Tino! He must want you for parts!
You can stay with me for the night, but after that you're on your own.
He's a droid. He can do whatever he wants. Oh yeah, this was the Imperial ship that crashed onto Tatooine. Halmoon's Cantina, yeah, sure. First order of business. Oh yeah, right. It was called the First Order. You got the First Order, and then you have the Final Order or something. I don't remember. The last time I've seen the Star Wars episode 7, 8, and 9, episode 9, I watched that as soon as it came out. I mean, Rick is here in the chat, he can vouch for me. We went to see that together.
Listen carefully. If you do exactly as I say, I can get you out of here.
What?
This is a rescue. I'm helping you escape.
Why do you want to help him escape,
because
though?
Because it's the right thing to do. You need a pilot. I need a pilot.
Does he need a pilot? Now think about it, episode 7 actually has the same premise as episode 4. I mean, a droid has plans that he shouldn't actually be able to... and the Empire or the First Order is after it.
That's not good.
I mean, they did get off the ship. But that's what I mean. I mean, I get it, you want more equality between men and women. What's the point in giving women the exact same story, but without any of the backlash attached to it?
Get ready.
Okay, that sounds really wrong now I think about it. But the thing is, the writers were actually... How do you say this? They were competent in what they were doing. They knew what they were doing with their story. Okay, what the fuck is this? You know, they wanted to make the character, in this case, a male, because most of the characters were male, most of the main characters. The inequality of the amount of females you see compared to the amount of males you see in movies and everything, I get it. You know, you want more females because there have been a lot of males. I don't understand why they don't write the female protagonist their story as well as they did with the original. But you can't make a story like this and then just expect people to like it. You know, there's nothing with Rey that's likable about it. She says, yeah, I can't do everything by herself. The entire moral of her story is that she can't do everything by herself. if that's, and the story is, it might be a good arc for her, but it's really poorly written. And I think that's the problem with most of the things you see nowadays, that most of them are just poorly written in terms of the motive and everything behind it. It's just the same old, same old. That's the problem that I have with movies nowadays, especially if there is a certain political agenda behind it. Because usually you just see a female protagonist being written because they are female, not because they actually have a story or anything behind it. But that's the biggest problem I got with movies nowadays, you know? They just write things because there's a political agenda behind it, not because there actually is a story behind it that's actually well written. And I don't like that anymore. It's just same old, same old. I don't want politics in my fucking movies, unless it's a movie about politics. I just want to see a movie because it's good, not because there is a woman playing the main role. But yeah, that's the problem with episodes 7, 8, and 9. A weird story, by the way, but I also lost something on vacation, but it was like 20 years ago. I actually did lose something on vacation. I had a teddy bear. Well, actually, it's an elephant. It's an elephant bear. But we left it at the parking lot. And I love that teddy bear. We left it at a parking lot in Belgium. So when we got home, we realized that it was gone. And yeah, we couldn't get it back anymore. I think. Or maybe we actually did get it back. I don't know anyway. I don't think we got it back, though. This guy, Snoke.
Fulfill your destiny.
Snoke would honestly make a good villain by its own. I mean, he can drag somebody on his legs. I mean, the General Hux scene was amazing. And I'm that serious about that. Snoke was an amazing villain. I mean, the amount of power he showcased. I'm not even kidding. The amount of power he showcased in episode 8 that he could just wield the force like none other before him was amazing. You know, you could just see the guy from the other side of the damn galaxy. We don't care about you, Holdo. I've never seen you before in my life. You and your bitches. I would love episode LXIX, by the way. If you don't know what that means, that's episode 69 in Greek letter, or Greek numerical, or I don't know if it's Latin or Greek. I think it's Greek. But I'm not that good anyway. So, Supreme Leader Kylo Ren is now going to visit the Emperor. I completely forgot how they actually got track of that the Emperor was still alive. I really don't know. I think that this all is just based on one and the same thing. You know, there's like one tiny little wire that connects these three movies together, and it's not a strong wire. Because, like I said, it's a tiny little wire. Where are we now, though? Are we still... is this Exegol? That seems like Mustafar. I don't know where that is. Yeah, this is Castle Run, if I remember correctly. Oh yeah, he found some sort of holocron, right? That if Star Wars Episode 7 would have said that Palpatine was still alive, because in Legends he is still alive. And hey, Dom. If Episode 7 would have stated that, like in Legends, that Palpatine was still alive, then this would actually made a great plot point to defeat Palpatine once and for all at the very end. And Episode 7 and 8 would be finding his hiding spot and finding his other clones, I guess. You know, and I don't know why Snoke would ever be a clone of Palpatine. I don't remember how that really worked. I find it funny that Rey can heal with the Force and she learned it from a book or some shit, but Anakin wasn't able to save it. Yeah. One of the biggest fucking problems with Star Wars right there. I mean, if they were able to save everyone they could, then there should be no more death in the universe for at least the people who, like, are close to Jedi or Sith. Oh yeah, they had more screen time than only an Exegol. The Knights of Ren, right? Oh no. I still don't know how this actually works with this foreseeing through one another, because they can't see one another, they know where they are, but can one inflict damage on the other's surroundings? So how do you make a Rey better? Well, let her be herself in the very end. Let her accept that she is a Palpatine. Because if she accepts that she's a Palpatine, but she's not Vaas Palpatine, so her grandfather, then she can turn the entire Palpatine line into something good instead of something Senate. Although that would kind of be bad, because I was actually rooting for the Senate the entire time during episode 9, but he still lost it in the very end. The bad guys always... Yeah, that's the thing, but it doesn't really matter to me that Palpatine lost. It's just that Rey doesn't accept that she's a Palpatine, even at the very end, because she's like, oh, but I'd rather be a Skywalker. But the thing is, she's a Palpatine. She will always be a Palpatine. There's nothing you can do about that. The thing with Palpatine is, especially if it's written like this, if he could clone himself into, or commission himself into, or put himself into someone else, then he can do this again and again and again. And then you can make episode 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18 with Palpatine as well. That's the problem with cloning Palpatine, because he just keeps coming and coming and coming if he transfers his essence into another body. Sans be like, oh shit, wrong position. Wait, was that actually in the movie? Did they put that in wrong of there as well? Is that the case? Is that why they did it? Because the movie showcased it being on this side and then all of a sudden on the other side. Is that really the problem? I saw what you did there. Okay. I saw the Aki turning off for some damn reason. But I enjoyed this game, honestly. I mean, the fact that I'm only at 30% just showcases how big this game actually is. It's 50 gigabytes in my PC anyway. But I will not be 100%ing this, because I've already put my time in this much with just 30%. And I think that I'm not gonna have the time for that, because I also have other games, I have streams. I got school back in September and everything. So, ladies and gentlemen, I just hope you all enjoyed this as much as I did. I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I hope to see you all again upcoming Thursday. Josh, by the way, good luck on your procedure. I'll say that right away. I will see you on Sunday or whatever. I hope you get home safely, let's just say it like that. And until next time, people.